major headaches and just blinding headaches.
It was November 2002. At first, Andy Delbridge thought he had a sinus infection. Then other more unusual symptoms appeared. Twice, he got lost coming home from work.
I went to, ended up in a little small town outside of Raleigh, and I called Nancy and said, I don't know how I got here. I'm not sure how to get back, but she helped talk me through to get back here. And then another day later, I came home and I got lost in my subdivision.
Andy, a hospital administrator, blamed his symptoms on stress. But when his doctor ordered an MRI, they found something much more serious.
The doctor came in and said, you know, there's going to be a surgery in your future. I'm not sure when it's going to be, but it's going to definitely be a surgery. And I said, well, what if, you know, okay, what if I don't do this surgery? He said, you will die.
Andy had a grade 4 brain tumor, also known as a glioblastoma multiforme, or GBM. His wife, Nancy.
I was in shock and wanted a second opinion. I just could not accept that it was what they were saying, stage 4 GBM, the worst kind of cancer known to man.
But there was more. Cancer had also invaded one of Andy's kidneys.
At first I thought, I'm dead. There's no hope and I don't want to die. And I didn't know where to go, what to do.
Most doctors considered Andy's case hopeless. Dr. Henry Friedman of Duke University Hospital says that's par for the course.
What are they going to tell him?
They're going to look
at
this
kind of a tumor.
They're going to look at this scan and they're going to say DEAD, dead. Or maybe DEADSOON, soon.
But Dr. Friedman and his colleagues see things differently. They believe that hope isn't just a catchphrase, it's essential to healing.
Hope is what gives you the strength and the fortitude to deal with an illness.
Surgeons removed Andy's brain tumor, but months of radiation and chemotherapy took their toll.
I remember the day that I got on my knees and was crying and said, God, please, please heal me. I need your healing. I need your touch, Father. And I just cried out.
I felt like I was having little panic attacks. Like, how am I going to care for these two little boys? How am I going to get a job? You know, I felt the weight of the world on me. It was a day-by-day thing, Tim. It wasn't so easy. It was moment by moment.
The Delbridges needed a hope even the medical profession couldn't offer. They found it in God's Word.
I had very weak faith, but I knew if I had faith of a mustard seed that I can make that grow. And so it grew and it grew, but I had to nourish it, and that was through the words of the Bible.
I was on an emotional roller coaster, but when I got into the Word, that was my rock. Jesus was my rock.
They and thousands of others prayed.
I trusted God at the same time I kept begging for that miracle. Please, I felt like a little child just begging and nagging and keeping on, please God, take this away, please heal my husband. And I felt like his little child and that he was carrying me.
Eventually, Andy's cancerous kidney was also removed. And for 2 years, he lived with no sign of cancer. Then in 2005, he received devastating news.
They had said there were two nodules close to Andy's heart that they could not biopsy because of the danger of puncturing the heart or the lungs. And then the other one was on the other kidney.
My God, how much can it keep going on? You know, please God, please God, please God, you know, remove this cancer. You know, I rebuke this cancer.
We just continued to pray, and he said, we'll do a CAT scan. Instead of waiting 2 months, we'll do it in about 5 weeks.
Yeah.
And you know, when they did the CAT scan, they were all gone, all three nodules gone, totally clear, and they remain clear now. And that was the greatest. I just thank you, Jesus. You know, without surgery, without chemotherapy, God did it. What man couldn't do, God did.
Today, Andy has a clean bill of health with no sign of cancer. Andy's back to one of his favorite pastimes, playing basketball with his two boys. He also loves talking about the miracle God gave him and his family.
There's hope. I mean, to me, this is kind of an equation. Hope equals faith, and faith equals God. You bring those together around, and God is there for us.
He came to rescue us from sin and sickness, to give us eternal life, and that means right now, knowing Jesus today.